Hi, I'm Chet Haas, an engineer on the Android team at Google. So I saw a talk recently at Google I.O. where they were showing some example animation code, which I always like. And I saw something curious there, which was someone said, well, we need to animate a couple of properties at the same time on the same target object, and we can't do that directly with ObjectAnimator, so we're going to use the ValueAnimator object and do it more manually. And I thought, that's not actually correct. So I realized at that point, I thought this was obvious how to do this, and I realized maybe it would be good if I actually explained how to do this in general. There's a class called PropertyValuesHolder that you might want to know about if you need to do this on your own targets and properties. So I have a demo to show you here with four simple buttons on it, all of which want to be animated. And you'll notice that all of them animate remarkably similarly. In fact, it's effectively the same animation happening on all of them, but the code for doing it is very different. So for the first button, we use a value animator animation. And this is the example that I saw in this particular talk. Said, okay, we're going to use value animator, and this will return a value between 0 and 1. And then we take this value, and we figure out what the values, what the target value should be on the target object that we're trying to animate. So I do that here. So the approach to doing this with a value animator is you create your value animator between start and end values. It doesn't actually matter what those values are because we're going to be using the animated fraction anyway. And then we add an update listener so that we get a callback on every single animation frame. And then during that frame, we get the animated fraction. This gives us a value between 0 and 1 to tell us where in the course of this animation the animation is. And then we can take that value and use it to interpolate the value of our end targets and end properties. So here we simply set the translation x and the translation y values directly on the object with a simple linear interpolation. And then we start the animation. Very straightforward, but there are easier ways to do this with a lot less code. The second one is probably the easiest way to do this. An important point to note here is I would always use view property animator in this particular situation. Right? I'm animating properties on a view, translation X and translation Y, and this is exactly why view property animator was created. The code is very simple and streamlined. You can do things in parallel in the same animation, and it's very efficient at animating multiple things because it has intrinsic knowledge about views that make its invalidation and rendering and update system very efficient internally. So it's the right thing to use. But sometimes you're animating things that aren't simply properties on a view, in which case you couldn't use view property animator, and you'll need to use one of the techniques that I show a little bit later. So if you can use view property animator, here's how it would work. You would call animate on the view, that returns a view property animator object, and then you would say translation x to the end value, translation y to the end value, and you're done. Don't need to call start, don't need to do these in separate statements. You're basically just building up the animation, and when you're done building it, it automatically starts in the next frame, and you're good to go. Straightforward, easy to use. Use view property animator. But if you can't, maybe you're looking at using object animators instead. So this is what's the example that I saw was trying to avoid, was creating multiple object animators, even though you're only animating one object. We all know that creating more and more objects, especially during animations, may be a bad thing, so maybe you want to avoid this. But it's fairly straightforward. This is maybe the trivial approach to solving this problem with an object animator, which is I want one object animator that animates the values for translation X. I want another object animator that animates the values for translation Y, and I want you to start both of them. Pretty simple. If you need to choreograph it a little more carefully, you can use an animator set, add these things in to play sequentially or play together or play with other animators. All very straightforward, not a big deal, but you are creating a couple of object animators that are sort of running without knowledge of each other, and maybe that's just not as efficient as what you really wanted to do. What you really wanted to do was the following. You want to use property values holders. This is actually what Object Animator uses internally, but you can access it on the outside too. In this case, we're animating the same object, but we're animating multiple properties on the same object in parallel. So what we're going to do is set up a properties value holder to animate our translation X property to the end value, another property values holder to animate the translation Y property on the same object, and then we're going to set up the Object Animator. And this is what associates the property values holders with the actual target object of our view. So now that we've set up the property values holder, we come down here and we create a single object animator, and we say, okay, on our target view, I want you to use this property values holder for translation X, the other property values holder for translation Y, and I want you to start it. And bang, you're done. So animating multiple properties in parallel on the same target object, view property animator if you can use it, property values holder if you can't. Thanks.